In this video, we're going to discuss the relationship between your own immune system and the Game of Thrones. It's very similar in that there's this game going on between your own white blood cells, or leukocytes, and pathogens, viruses, bacteria, fungus, mold. Pathogens are those microbes that cause disease. And there's another part of your immune system that I want to discuss. A very, very long time ago, there was a union created between your own cells and bacteria. And they formed a mutually beneficial relationship. And we now call that bacteria friendly bacteria. They have become a big part of our immune system in helping defend against the unfriendly bacteria and other pathogens. So in this video, I want to take clips out of the Game of Thrones and help you understand the immune system. The Night's Watch is a military order dedicated to holding the wall, the immense fortification of the northern border of the Seven Kingdoms, led by Lord Commander Gior Mormont. Any enemy trying to invade the Seven Kingdoms beyond the wall will have to get past the guards, the Night's Watch. They are always on duty to protect the realms of men from whatever is out there. The exact same thing happens in your body. You have guards that monitor the wall 24/7. They're called macrophages, and they're large cells that eat. They eat viruses, bacteria, and they monitor and guard the wall. And in your body, you have the external skin and internal skin lining. All the internal skin that lines your nose, your lungs, your throat, and your gastrointestinal tract are so large it would cover 400 square meters, the size of two tennis courts. So these macrophages have a tremendous job in protecting against invading pathogens. In this next example, we have Jon Snow becoming the Lord Commander of the Night's Watch, which rules over everyone there. And as time goes on, he rises up to become the King of the North. And of course, the goal of his enemies is to take him out. Taking out the commander or the king is a very successful strategy to win the war. So in the body, we have certain T cells, okay? And this stands for thymus. The thymus is the gland that helps train your white blood cells to help defend against pathogens. Now, the two parts of the immune system are the innate and the acquired. The innate is a part of the immune system that you're born with. The acquired is a part of the immune system that needs training. You need to expose your immune system to germs and microbes and allow the infection to occur to overcome it so it becomes stronger. So you develop your immunity from experience. But there's one central white blood cell that is the commander or the coordinator for the entire immune system. And it's called the T helper cell. This is the boss that coordinates the attack. It judges on how many white blood cells the body needs to create, how much weaponry, what type of weaponry, so that your immune system can be successful. Now, on the other side of the game, we have certain pathogens, viruses, specifically the HIV virus, that has its own strategy of taking out the head commander of the entire organization. So this virus goes after the T helper cells and destroys the cell. And that's its strategy to winning the war. In the final battle for King's Landing, Daenerys Targaryen instructs her dragon to not just kill specific enemies, but to destroy the entire city, killing off not just the enemies, but the good people as well, creating massive collateral damage. Now, in the immune system, you have something called a T regulatory cell. It has two main functions. One is to determine the good guys from the bad guys, to prevent traitors and rogue elements to invade the body, but it also has a very important function that relates to the example you just saw in regulating the attack or weaponry that our immune system releases. So you can think of the T regulatory cells as the water that puts out the fire or the inflammation in the body. And if we don't have these cells in place, we can't put out the fire, and we get this massive inflammatory condition that creates a lot of collateral damage. Now, anytime a person tries to enter a city or a wall, the guards have to determine who that person is. Are they a friendly person or an enemy? So this is a very important job, and there's all sorts of mechanisms in place to be able to differentiate who's good, who's bad, and to allow only the friendly cells to invade the body and kill any of the pathogens. Now, as time goes on, Jon Snow, through experience, becomes more and more knowledgeable about how to kill his enemies, specifically the White Walkers. He learns about their strengths and their weaknesses. And one weakness they have is dragon glass, which is then used as one of the weapons to fight them. Now, in the immune system, and I'm talking about the acquired immune system that learns from experience, we have the B cell. B stands for bone marrow, because that's where it originates from. So we have this cell that releases antibodies. So when we're exposed to germs, these antibodies interact with the germs and create memories. So the next time when they're in a battle, they're exposed to a specific pathogen, they have this memory and they know what to do. So in other words, your body develops antibodies over time to deal with specific germs. And so now they are prepared and they will bind with viruses and bacteria and neutralize them before they can invade the cell. So Littlefinger, in secret, makes a deal with the City Watch.
All is accomplished. The City Watch is yours.
Good.
And this deal relates to turning against Ned Stark.
We stand behind you, Lord Stark.
So later, when Ned Stark gives an order, the Gold Cloaks turn against Ned and end up killing all of his soldiers. And so the City Watch becomes traitors.
I did warn you not to trust me.
Now, in the immune system, we have a very similar thing happening. Certain mechanisms involving viruses cause our own body to create what's called autoantibodies, which are antibodies against our own tissue. You can look at this as friendly fire or a part of your own cells becoming traitors and attacking its own tissue. So you see this a lot in autoimmune disease, and many times an autoimmune condition is triggered by a virus. One of the scariest abilities the White Walkers have is the power to create creatures known as whites. Whites are reanimated corpses, which continue to live as zombies who are under control of the White Walkers. So when we're talking about normal cells, they have a certain limit to how long they can live. So it could be months, it could be a couple years, but eventually these cells die. But what happens when normal cells become damaged, certain cells switch over to cancerous cells. And the way they do that is through a certain adaptation mechanism, which their metabolism is actually changed to a completely different way of burning fuel. And the other very unique thing about cancer cells is they lose their ability to die and they become immortal, just like the zombies that you just saw. So cancer cells are zombie cells that are no longer under your own body's control. And they pretty much have their own brain where they can take over, they invade different areas of inflammation, and they can potentially kill you, just like the White Walkers. Now, normally in the immune system, you have the natural killer cell over here on the innate part of the immune system. And then on the acquired, you have the T killer cells that are specialists in attacking cancer cells. This game or battle has been going on for a very long time. The goal of our immune system is to kill the cancer cells, and the cancer cells also have a goal of surviving. And they can survive under various conditions. They can survive under conditions where there's no oxygen, and sometimes they go into dormancy and come back out of remission, even after chemotherapy. So we have tried many things to try to kill off cancer, but our best strategy is really to take care of our own immune system and make sure the natural killer cells and the T cells are strong enough to prevent cancer from growing in the first place. And then we have the Red Woman, who is part of the Fiery Hand, who uses the weapon of fire, not to mention the pyromancers who specialize in fire. And then we have individuals that use poison as their weapon, as in the Red Viper. Now, in the immune system, we have a very similar situation. There is a lot of inflammation, which we could look at as fire, which makes it very, very hard for a pathogen to live. And certain immune cells use these inflammatory type cytokines in their defense mechanism, as well as using other poisons like bleach and hydrogen peroxide, and another one called interferon, which is a chemical that interferes with the viral reproduction. So in the Battle of Blackwater, a certain weapon was used to destroy the ships, to weaken their defenses.
Masters, get down!
Now, in the immune system, exact same thing happens. You have viruses, you have bacteria, you have other microbes that literally have this strategy of turning down your receptors for vitamin D. Vitamin D is essential for your immune system to work, but not if it's turned off. They also deplete your zinc, which is also essential, and your vitamin C. So without these key nutrients, your immune system is susceptible. It's vulnerable to continued infection. The faceless men can use the faces of people they kill to infiltrate the enemy and kill who they need to quietly. Arya Stark learns this technique and puts it to good use. Now, a similar thing happens in the immune system. So certain viruses and other microbes like mycoplasma, nanobacteria have various strategies. One of the strategies that a virus might use is to act as one of our own and be camouflaged as one of our own cells. So they can go undetected and enter the cell and create havoc. Other strategies that nanobacteria use, which are very, very small bacteria, is to literally build a shell, a calcium shell around them. Sort of like an igloo or like a little dome that they can hide in and be protected. Another name for that is a biofilm. So your immune system has a real hard time finding these microbes. So the goal of any front line of defense is to hold the fort. When Tyrion Lannister was fighting Stannis Baratheon at the Battle of the Blackwater, Tyrion was about to lose the battle until the reinforcements finally arrived.
The battle is over. We have won.
So you can look at it like this. The innate part of the immune system is the first line of defense. The acquired, another name would be adaptive, is the second line of defense, which normally takes between 5 and 7 days. So in this next scene, we have Sansa Stark, who finally identifies Littlefinger's true motive with the help of her brother, Bran Stark, to finally figure out who is the real instigator behind so many situations. So in the immune system, we have a similar thing. Immune cells work together. So on the acquired side of the immune system, we have the T killer cells, which are the assassins, like the special forces that do the killing, okay? And then you have the B cells, which make antibodies. B cells don't necessarily kill the enemy. They identify or tag the enemy. So here's a virus. They put a little flag in there, kill me. So then the T killer cell can find the enemy and kill it. All right, guys, so there you have it. The comparison of Game of Thrones to the game of your own immune system between the battle of pathogens and white blood cells. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely, you have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.